permanent? Cook house duty was conferred upon private college. And he left. He moved out. This person. Later it became a joke for all of the privates. They really had a hearty laugh. They really enjoyed the thing like that. And of course, things, time passes by, it went on. And one day, my friend, the author says, his friend and another one were talking about it. It was just passing by the cookhouse. They were just somehow moving by the cookhouse. And what had happened? They heard, suddenly, they got alert. What for? They heard some voice coming. Same droning, lingering one voice was coming from the cookhouse. So they just stood there, peeked in to see what was that. Through the open door, we could see three cooks standing against the wall as it of a bay. And from within came the monotonous beat of that familiar voice. Because Professor Venn used to lecture, it was a monotonous, lingering, going on and on, that voice was there. Really? I must protest against this abominably scientific, unscientific and unhygienic method of peeling potatoes. I need to only draw your attention to your sheer waste of vitamin values and blah, 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 blah. Who was that? Of course, the private. The private quelled. After given, actually he got a demotion. It was a demotion. He was demoted to that post. Who was asking for a promotion, actually was demoted. In spite of that, he remained undeterred. Undeterred of his what? Of his characteristics. And yet, after so much of humiliation and emotion, yet after that he kept on lecturing. This time for about what? He was lecturing on peeling of the potatoes, a scientific and very hygienic way of peeling of the potatoes. I don't know how it's possible, but he knew it better because he was a well-read man. One thing that I had been telling you, that you know, when he used to deliver a lecture and when he used to tell people about certain things, even personal things also, he would come out with various of opinions. Some other privates asked him also, how can you manage remembering so much? He used to say, intelligent reading. That is a fact. When we read, how you read, that is also very important. He knew what to remember and how much to remember. Only one thing he lacked. With intelligent reading comes a common sense also. That common sense he lacked. Okay? So, he was still delivering the lecture and privates all had their own, I'm sure later they were given their commission, they were given their stripes and whatever. They had moved on. God knows what happened to Private Quelch. This shows a person with lot of potential, lot of values, lot of intelligence, and we can say tremendous power of doing something, doing some magic in the world, also fail just because the person does not have kind of common sense and awareness about the same. In the army, it is very important to maintain a protocol and to know when to speak and how much to speak. If the person doesn't know about it, he doesn't deserve to be in army, because army rules and discipline is a must. So this is a story and this is how it ends up. Now, after the story, the main theme of the story has to be discussed, and let's see what was the main theme all about. We have to develop the points on that. So, in this whole story, we get to see the main three points, and to denote three points in Avadhan, we used triangle, of the story. What was the theme of the story? That we have got to, we could go, get to see that. The first point comes is, knowledge is very important. We all know that. A knowledgeable person can deal lot many troubles and lot many odds in life. But then, this is also very important, so we should know when and where to use it. where to use it. This is what Private Quelch lacked. He had knowledge. His knowledge was very important. He definitely attained a lot of respect from other people because of his knowledge. But he did not know how and where to use it. This is also very important. And along with knowledge, one very important thing comes, common sense. Without common sense, none of us can survive. Common sense is the most important part. So these are the three very important factors of this theme, and the points that is taken should be taken as a theme. In Avadhan, we denote it with the triangle. Now after that, the question answers that are desirable and definitely will be asked after the lessons get over. So we take them one by one. The first one that we do is one. Why was Private Quelch called a professor? This comes the first question. And the answer that we can develop by this is, during the chapter only I had told you, his physical appearance that looked like a professor, of course. Though he was a young chap, but then his appearance was lanky. Lanky means, you know, hangered like, stooped, sort of, stooping. Wearing horn-rimmed spectacles. Looked like a professor. That was not the end. Along with physical appearance, his behavior also. How was it behavior? His behavior was, he had a habit of lecturing. He was knowledgeable, no doubt. He had a tremendous habit of exhibiting his knowledge. Monotonous way of speaking the same thing on and on, and monotonous voice and speaking on every topic. And another very, very irritating personality that he had got was correcting others. This was the reason for his downfall. So these are all reasons for which he was called a professor: physical appearance and the behavioring pattern. Next comes another question that will be a little longer question. Why did fellow trainees develop a dislike for Private Quelch? For Quelch. The whole story actually revolves around this central idea. Initially he was respected, he was admired by all because of his knowledge. As we can refer, initially he was admired. But later what happened? This comes like this. The first we can write, he always pinpointed and corrected others. This was his terrific problem. And corrected others, which was definitely disliked by his fellow folks. He heckled them. Heckled them means pulled them down. With unnecessary enthusiasm. He deliberately tried to pull them others in front of the seniors. His intention of getting stripe, I explain you what is the meaning of stripe, became clear to others, before others. It was all he was doing. It was, you know, it was just stripe. Deliberately he was trying to malign others' images just to get his stripe. This actually was caught by his fellow folks. They understood that whatever that he was doing was nothing but just to get the stripe. Though the others did not do anything to harm him, but he, in his way, by showing up his knowledge, he was trying to harm others. His harm was very much clear by his fellow friends. And that is why they started developing a dislike towards him. Okay? This will be our question of 70 to 80 words. Now after this, there comes another question. It's a very common one. Character sketch of Private Quench. This was one of the, another thing. When we talk about character sketch of Private Quench, it's not a very difficult thing to know because it is a portrait. It is actually his portrait all about. He was, first point that we can take up is, he was dedicated and committed. He was determined to get the stripe, focused and determined to become an army officer. He was an avid reader. This we also have to know. Why? Why was so he dedicated, focused and all? And how he could exhibit his knowledge that he was an avid reader. Avid means actually dipped into reading, okay? But one thing, the trouble that he had was, he was hard working enthusiastic. That was no doubt. But one thing, the problem was that he lacked common sense. He tremendously lacked common sense. That was one of his biggest attributes and the reason for his main downfall. He did not realize hierarchy of army. Anyone who is joining army has to know that army follows a set pattern of hierarchy rules that has to be followed. He did not know that. And his over ambition over enthusiasm led to his downfall. This is the basic things. All these points are to be covered, that he was dedicated, committed, focused and determined though to become an army officer. He was an avid reader. That was one of the greatest attributes, or we can say his greatest characteristic, that he read a lot and really read well, and that is why he could speak in front of others. That was a very important thing. He was hardworking, enthusiastic and lacked common sense. He did not realize the hierarchy of the army. His over-ambition, over-enthusiasm led to his downfalls. So these all things were the reason for to derive a character sketch of Private Welch. Now one more important question that can be taken up is, at first, Private Welch was a hero. How did he invite his downfall? This has to be understood. In the beginning, Private Welch was a hero in others' eyes. How did he invite his downfall? Now, this is one very important aspect of it. When he came to that army camp, he was filled with enthusiasm, naturally, and others were also very, very much appalled by his knowledge. So naturally he became a hero. Everyone was filled with awe. Due to what? Because of his knowledge. They felt he knew everything. And the way he exhibited his knowledge, that also was credential. It added to his credibility. Okay? Later they realized that habit, or we can say tendency, to exhibit his knowledge. That was very killing. Slowly, they developed a dislike. Naturally, when a person tries to continuously exhibit the knowledge to impress others, that is not a very likable gesture. Nobody likes that. Okay? Moreover, a habit of correcting others. This was another very bad habit that he had got. Last but not the least, he made a mistake, or we can say a blunder, of correcting none else but Corporal Turnbull. This was a very, very important thing, or we can say the most atrocious thing that he did, and that is how he got invited to his downfall. These all things, initially people were filled with awe. They were mesmerized. They were appalled by his knowledge. And then they felt that he knew everything. In fact, many of them actually approached Professor Private Quelch for asking help, seeking help. He did so. But later they realized that it was actually nothing but exhibiting of knowledge, because when personal time, when they went to him, that time he did not come out with lot of help and all. He deliberately did it when the seniors were around. So that was obvious. People understood that. And then slowly they started developing a dislike. Since he could not make a very good, you know, association, or we can say pally with the other privates, so nobody wanted to tell him that it was his drawback. And then he started habit of correcting others. He dared to correct his seniors, which was definitely a very, very derogatory kind of a behavior that was in the army. And then he committed a blunder, or we can say mistake, of correcting Corporal Turnbull, which ultimately led to his downfall. So that is the way we need to develop this question. This question also will be in 70 to 80 words. So this is the end of the chapter that we had done, and how this common sense, lack of common sense, can lead a downfall to a person. This is the whole story all along.